very, very difficult to make ends meet.
CBC News learns dozens of Royal Bank employees are losing their jobs, and they say they're being replaced by temporary workers from overseas. Ottawa says the situation is unacceptable if true and is looking into the matter. Well, the bank says it's trying to find new positions for those displaced. Zabeen Hirji is the Chief Human Resources Officer for RBC, and she joins me now in our Toronto studio. Thanks for being here. What's your reaction to these allegations?
Thank you, Christine, for having me here. I think where I would really start with this is we need to make sure we have clarity around some of the facts. And what is important here is that RBC has not hired temporary foreign workers to replace our employees. That's, I think, a good place to start. And so really, as we look at this particular situation, we're working with a supplier, as companies do with many suppliers, and we're now going through the transition process as the work transitions over to them.
I'm not sure I understand, because correct me if I'm wrong, but the workers are in RBC offices doing RBC work, and people are being let go as a result.
Yeah, let me explain that. So as we are in the early process of moving the work over to another supplier, and as part of that process, it's actually typically the suppliers would bring their employees into our workplace so that they understand how our processes work and what the current state is in order to be able to migrate it. And those employees of the supplier then, the majority of them actually
let me understand this. So you're saying the employees of the supplier are doing the work that the RBC employees are doing now?
Well, what's happening?
Because our understanding is that current employees have been asked to train those employees, and they are as a result being let go. So I'm not seeing the connection here, but I understand that you are committed to trying to find all of these employees who've been laid off jobs. Is that true?
Yeah, so we can let the sort of connection piece, we can set that aside, but it is the transitionary process. And absolutely, we take working with our employees in situations like this very seriously. It's something that we have a strong track record of working with our employees, because we have many initiatives where there are changes and enhancements. So in a situation like this, Christine, what would have happened? On the heels of the announcement, we would bring in expertise to work with them to help the employees brush up their resumes and really get them comfortable with their own skills and their own, even their aspirations. What's the type of work that they want to do? And some employees actually also choose to leave.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's the process that we're going through, where we have a number of employees that are already placed in other roles. And over the next few months, we will work with the employees to help them find work within RBC.
You said a number of employees, but our understanding is that there are only 5 that have new jobs with RBC. We're talking about 40-something employees, and they're leaving at the end of the month. It doesn't sound like there's a number of them finding other opportunities within the company.
So with this particular group, at the moment, we have about 18 employees that are either placed, they're going to continue on some of this work, that are going to be in other parts of the organization, and some, as I mentioned, they choose to retire early, and of course we support them through that. And while we start with a window that we want to work in, because we want to make sure people take this seriously and we're working with them seriously, typically what we would do is we would extend that if we haven't found roles for people that actually want to stay.
So just so that we understand, are you saying 18 of those employees have actually found new positions within instead of just 5 of them?
That's correct. The 18 of them have found positions, and some of those, or a small number there, that actually have chosen voluntarily to retire.
Oh, okay, so it's not actually even 18.
It's a small number.
Okay, well, so the government has reacted, mm-hmm. saying this is unacceptable. How do you react to that allegation that this goes against Canada's citizenship and immigration rules?
So I think the word that you use there is very important, which is the allegation. And what I would say is we've already been in conversation with the government departments last week as this came forward, and we are working with them as we do in any situation, very cooperatively, because it's in everybody's best interest for the rules and regulations to be followed.
I understand that RBC has been working with iGATE since 2005. Is RBC aware that they were charged with discriminating against American citizens back in 2008?
Yeah. We have been working with iGATE for quite some time. And really, I think, you know, in terms of the situation that we're talking about here and the use of temporary foreign workers, I think really the point I'd like to make is that it's not RBC that has hired these employees.
Again, I would challenge you on it to say it sounds like, and if you're saying this is not true, those people have come in to do the work that RBC employees are doing right now. Is that correct? They're doing RBC work.
If those people are here to transition the work over to the processes and systems that iGATE uses.
Mm. I think there's something in semantics there, and I get what you're trying to sell, but I'm not sure I'm buying it. Canadian banks regularly post huge profits. How do you guys justify a move like this? You're still putting 45 workers out of their jobs.
As I say, we are working with the 45 workers, working very diligently with a lot of focus, and we have a track record. Productivity improvements are something that happen as much in the private sector as the public sector. That's something that's ongoing. It's actually good for the productivity and competitiveness of our country.
Mm-hmm.
And so with that really being the business models in place, the models in government, our focus really turns to how do we work with our employees to help them find appropriate roles. And in a company like ours, it's something we've actually, because employees move around
mm-hmm.
all the time, we're actually very good at moving people around.
Does it mean, you know, you're talking about the employees and how mm-hmm. they feel in this situation.
Mm-hmm.
There was a quote from one of your employees that stuck out to me. She'd said that the bank is doing this while making billions of dollars in record profits. We are like fleas on an elephant. That's what your employees were
mm-hmm.
saying. How do you react to that?
Yeah, it's unfortunate to hear a comment like that. I can appreciate that our employees are going through. This is difficult for employees to go through. We understand that. It's normal with a change, with any type of change, for employees to go through that. So we really, for us, it's important to have open dialogue, to have ongoing conversations, and really work with our employees to get them through the change process.
Mm-hmm. You know, since we started airing this story, we've had huge reaction
mm-hmm.
Online and social media, and we're seeing your customers reacting very strongly to this story, some going as far as to say they'll move their money elsewhere. What's your reaction?
Yeah, I think really, Christine, what's important here to emphasize is moving your processes and some of the operations to other suppliers is a business practice both within Canada and globally that is very well established. And so it's really important, I think, to have the facts out there so that our customers also have a understanding of what the situation is and what our commitment to working with people is.
Zabeen, thanks so much for taking the time to speak with us.
Thank you for having me.
Zabeen Hirji, Chief Human Resources Officer for RBC, reacting to the CBC News investigation about Royal Bank employees being replaced by temporary workers from overseas.